Hello, we're Abby and Gaz, and in June 2023, we quit our jobs to pursue our dreams of full-time travel. We're currently 3 weeks into our three-month India trip, and so far, we have been loving the adventure India brings, from the amazing food, friendly locals, and absolute chaos around every corner. In this episode, we are in the laid-back town of Pushkar, situated in between the famous cities of Jaipur and Jodhpur. Pushkar is famous for its relaxed hippie vibes and spiritualism deeply rooted in the Hindu faith. However, the spiritual haven has also attracted some dishonest individuals. This almost ruined our time here, but like most days in India, every down moment is followed by an amazing up. Hit subscribe and let's jump into the video.
Hello everybody and welcome to Pushkar.
We're currently on our way to the main area walking from our
hostel. Dodging cows, may I add. Yeah. There are so many cows here. We've seen the odd cows around the city, but literally they're another level, like they're around every corner, multiple big cows.
So let's see what else we can find today, but we're excited, aren't we?
We are.
So we've got tons of souvenir shops with loads of beautiful clothes in them, which is like, no, it's giving like more island vibes kind of feel than
this
like...
This place is giving off Pai vibes in Thailand.
Yeah.
It's like hip, proper like hippie shops and hippie stores. And then you walk around the corner and you've still got like the carnage of India, like...
Okay, so you might think it's very uncultured that our first stop of the day is an international bakery, but they also do loads of really good Indian food. Obviously, I've got myself a croissant, why wouldn't I? But apparently there's a really cool camel fair here in November that is one of the biggest camel fairs in the world, and that has brought lots of tourists and international food and stuff.
All right, if you've been watching our videos recently, I've been on a mission to get a dosa, and for some reason nowhere in any of the cities have been serving them, but we've just got one here, and my God, I don't know if they're usually this big, but it's absolutely humongous. I don't know how to eat it.
I'd say just start ripping it off.
Just rip it off? And just, like, hold it?
Just flake a bit off. There you go.
I got a masala one, by the way.
And then there's like,
it looks like some form of like dal kind of dip.
It's good.
Like a crispy wrap with potato. Oh yeah, it's really good. Probably one of my favourite things I've eaten so far.
Hello.
Hello. Here we are, we've got the lake of Pushkar, which is really famous because apparently Lord Brahma, which is the creator god in Hinduism, dropped a lotus flower on top of a demon here in the desert and it formed a lake, and that's what Hindus believe. So it's a very, very sacred lake. So it's super beautiful. It feels really, really peaceful here actually. I thought when I was picturing what it was going to look like, it'd be a lot busier around the edge, like with restaurants and stuff, but the ghats,
it's a place of worship, isn't it?
Place of worship, yeah. But the ghats, if anyone doesn't know what they are, they're the steps that go down into the water. They're everywhere, and then obviously there's people in them over that side bathing and stuff in the water. Very, very relaxing, actually, to walk around, isn't it?
It is, yeah. Very India, so we're walking around the serene, religious lake, and then we've just come up to the walk past this cafe on the lake that's playing absolute raging techno music. It's like, okay.
You always get one extreme to the other here. So I read in an article that these chalk lines on the floor are used to guide people to a wedding. And we have seen loads of weddings going on here. I wonder if it's just like a popular place for weddings.
It's like Google Maps, but without the phone.
Yeah. So you got one laser up there. I don't know if you can see him right on the roof. And then there's another one. He just jumped. Oh, I don't know about him, like. So we've been walking around the lake now, and literally all we've seen is souvenir shops, well, clothes shops more like, isn't it?
Yeah, and obviously there's like dozens, if not hundreds of temples that you can go down onto the lake on as well.
Exactly.
It's crazy how it's like half tourist, like it's like proper like souvenir shops, touristy, and obviously like a massive place of pilgrimage as well, isn't it?
Yeah, so can we go down, should we go down there? Morning. Thank you.
As we went to explore our first temple, we were quickly approached by someone forcing a flower into our hands. This was actually a man who I recognised from another YouTube video as a scammer.
That's the same guy. That's the guy that's scammed. guy's trying to scam us with a flower, getting quite aggressive about it. Asking me why, oh, there's cow crap on the floor, Abby.
Oh, yeah.
There's a cow there. Asking me why I won't take the flower, getting quite aggressive about it. Because you're going to try and scam me, mate.
There's loads, can you hear that? There's loads of pigeons on the roof, literally. Why is there so many on the roof? That's
there's
the guy, can you
there.
See him?
Yeah, should we go down?
Oh, my God, there's a cow right
Let's
behind
go back
us,
up.
I'm scared.
Abby, there's shit everywhere.
I know. But there's now loads of cows behind us. Oh, God, they're all coming down as well. Oh, my God.
Okay, so that was only a very, very quick pit stop at that gap. To be honest, it wasn't very spiritual for us. The guy just wouldn't leave us alone, trying to sell us food, flowers, etc. Then getting quite aggressive when we just said no, we didn't want to. Although we had, and just to note, we had already put a donation in the box for the temple, and then there were literally, techno everywhere. Come on, baby. The whole steps were covered in like cow wee and cow crap, and we had to take our shoes off, so we were like, there's so many more gaps that are like clean and quiet and nobody's on, so we're gonna go and find one of those to go down. This one looks a lot more peaceful, doesn't it?
Yeah,
which is what I expected. Yes, this is nice. Now this one is 10 times more stunning than the last one, isn't it? And you can actually see all of the other temples. There's our starting point as well, so we've actually made it, well, 3/4 of the way around the lake. We've almost done the lap around the lake, which is quite cool.
Look, there's a heron or something feeding.
A heron there. There's so much wildlife. Would you call it wildlife? Like cows, monkeys. I guess it is wildlife.
Yeah, animals.
It? So many animals in India, but this one is nice and peaceful, actually. Yeah. And it is beautiful on the lake when you take yourself away from the carnage. Oh, here we go. Here we go.
Thank you.
It's okay.
No.
We don't want it.
No, thank you.
We don't want it. Thank you. No.
This is honestly what it's like, but this guy was way less pushy than other people have been. Like, they literally just try and force it on you.
Yeah. And we saw before we came that they try and charge you like £100 or like £200 after you've taken a blessing. It's honestly so frustrating that people would use religion to then use it as a scam. Like, it's just a joke, really. But apparently that, like, this scam has become very, very well known now. Like, we read up on it before we even came, so we knew it straight away, and I'd seen it in some YouTube videos. So thankfully we've done our research, but yeah, the fact that it's become well known as a scam here is just a bit of a shame, really, because obviously it's a very spiritual religious place and it's beautiful, so why can't we just enjoy it without having to be scammed? It's a shame, but anyway, we've managed to dodge it, so we can still relax now.
I mean, that guy was fine, like, but the one in the other place would not leave as well.
Just like, take it. It's like, we don't want it. But yeah, anyway, it is what it is.
We're going to that temple up there, somewhere around there next. I can't get my finger to point it in the camera, but there's a massive fun cable car all the way up. I'm not sure if it's actually working today, though, because it's not moving, basically.
Oh, let's hope so.
Yeah, I'm not walking up it. Yeah, it looks like quite a climb, but we shall find out.
Surrounded by two ladies in pink there as well, girls. Did you see that?
I didn't, no.
Oh. And that was the wedding from the pink and white stripes you saw earlier. So we actually ended up following them all the way to their wedding venue.
Come
There's
the
camels. Try and 10 rupees.
Yeah, probably not for us, but we heard you.
Yeah, we heard you. We'll be coming back for our 10 rupees chai later.
It says 20 on there.
So 20 minutes until it opened, 165 rupees per person.
Yeah, that's fairly reasonable. I would have paid 500 to not walk up here.
We would normally walk, but because we're both feeling a bit ropey today, it's best to leave the walking for people who want to get sweaty. We need to really be relaxing and recovering from Gaz's from his cold, me from a dodgy stomach. So what do you do when you wait?
We're a right pair today, aren't we?
Yeah. But what do we do when we wait? We go and get a nice cold drink. See what this guy's got. This one.
Don't mind.
Yes, we want Coke. Have you got Coke? Coca-Cola?
Yes.
Okay.
It's massive Coke.
Coca-Cola.
Yeah.
Fanta? You want to share a bottle of Fanta?
No.
Fanta.
Yeah, I get that.
Fanta.
Fanta,
thank you.
How's that going?
How much for this one?
50.
50.
So we would usually get a chai, but it's actually very warm today, so gone for a nice ice cold Fanta instead. Thank you. Danny West.
Right, top of that.
Look at this dog.
I feel like I'm at a theme park.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, we don't have to do that.
I wouldn't have expected a cable car in India, though. Doesn't feel like a very India thing, does it?
No.
But we'll take it. Oh, just bash your hand. Hopefully we get some good views.
How much do you trust this cable car?
It's not that much.
I'm at about 75% trust level.
Thank you.
Hello. Namaste.
Where are you from?
England.
England?
Yeah.
Remember to outside my
ears. Ah.
This way.
Where are you from?
Hello.
Hampi.
MP. Indore.
So that's cleanest city in India.
Ah, yeah. Oh, nice. We made some friends
with the people in our cable car. We've been chatting away and they've subscribed to our YouTube channel, haven't you? What's your name? Want to say hello?
My name is Ashley Verma.
Say hello.
Hi. Hi, everyone.
We've got some beautiful views here as well. You want to say hello?
Hello.
What's your name?
Adi Verma.
Nice to meet
Gaz.
You.
We spent the rest of the cable car chatting away. It's times like these when you get a real authentic connection with people that really make our day here in India. The situations with the scammers earlier were long forgotten.
Thank you.
Welcome. Nice to meet you.
Oh, which way? I was out here.
See you later.
Bye.
Bye.
That was a fun little journey, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was fun until we stopped right hanging off the cliff.
Yeah, but then we went on the side.
But then, yeah, it was fun.
30 seconds for like viewing.
Yeah.
Oh my god, there's so many monkeys. Okay, take your shoes off. What if the monkeys stole your shoes?
Look how many monkeys there are. There's literally hundreds of monkeys. Get off my shoes! Look, they look very mischievous as well. The family of mums over there, they look nice. The dad's picking the mum's tail and the mum's thing in. Loads of baby monkeys. These ones look mischievous though. Oh look. God. Painting.
That is actually wild. This guy is literally painting the side of that building and he's hung by a string. Literally just painting like that, that's literally mental. We've got a proper epic scenery out here. I didn't expect Pushkar to look this big from up above, do you?
And
it feels smaller than that down when you're on the floor.
And it's super clear as well, isn't it? Like,
yeah, compared to the other cities where we've had loads and loads of pollution, this is like the first clear shot we've got in a long time. Check this out, this is actually stunning.
So one side we've got Pushkar, the beautiful lake, obviously the busy city, and then behind me here, it essentially just goes out into the mountains and desert and beyond. Nothing out there but camels and no water. Yeah. Very beautiful. He's trying to get food off people. Abby is petrified of monkeys.
Don't go until I'm ready.
All right, well, tell me when you're ready.
I just don't want them to go near me.
They're not going to come near you.
How do you know?
Because I'll stop them. Look, there you go, look.
Okay. Come on. You go here. Just follow me.
Gaz!
Look, they got it on film, that was funny. Cool.
Oh, it's funny. Like, it's always so full of joy and excited all the time. Yeah. There's just like never a peaceful moment, but that's the fun of India. Like, if you want peace, stay inside. Literally, like, how fun is that? Like,
no, I wouldn't even say if you want peace, stay inside, because we've had a brass band outside for 2 days.
We were literally resting there, like cable car against cable car, and they're singing and waving at each of it. It's just lovely. It brings joy to my heart.
A few hours later, we headed back out to hopefully get a more authentic experience of Pushkar's spiritual side.
So we've headed back down to Pushkar Lake because we've heard that it's like a Hindu ceremony that goes on around sunset time called, we think it's pronounced Aarti, if not, correct me in the comments below. But we are slightly early because
the sun's still up.
The sun's still up pretty much, but we're just chilling out here and taking it in. It feels actually really peaceful and calm now compared to earlier. I mean, it was peaceful earlier, but I don't know, people are just sat kind of looking out onto the lake, reflecting and not really talking too much. Everyone's just kind of relaxing.
Soon the atmosphere started to change and you could tell something was about to happen.
So peaceful here until that guy, that little kid just doing a wheelie along with the gas on his bike.
So the sky is now turning pink and we can see the flames all in the distance. And what was quite funny is the cows came walking around the lake following the chanting. Obviously, to them, that is their god, so it's a holy animal for them. So it's like they're walking over to the rituals around the edge. In the distance, we can see fire, we can see people bathing in the lake as well. And you can tell, obviously, with the chanting and the sun going down, it does feel very spiritual. After watching the ceremony, we headed back into town to grab ourselves a delicious pizza. We ended the day in high spirits, feeling content that we got to witness an important religious ceremony in Hinduism. We had a great time in Pushkar and didn't let a few dishonest people taint our view of this interesting town. It's a shame that scams like that are allowed to happen, but you have to look past these things to find the good in India, and the good came very easily today. If you want to slow down and relax in between the crazy cities in Rajasthan, then we would definitely recommend coming here. Make sure you hit the subscribe button, give us a thumbs up if you like the video, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye!